So P53 mutation is the most difficult population to treat in acute myeloid leukemia. And there was a hope that venetoclax in combination with hypomethylating agents will change the outcomes of these patients who historically have done extremely poorly. Notably, the population of P53 mutated AML patients tend to have complex cytogenetics, enriched in the therapy-related acute myeloid leukemia, and have had history of prior myelodysplastic syndrome and commonly used hypomethylating agents to treat those. In this subset analysis, we compared the outcomes of patients who had wild-type P53 and patients who had mutant P53, who were treated in the prospective clinical trial, phase two clinical trial of 10-day decitabine with venetoclax. We accrued 37 patients with mutant P53 and 84 patients with wild-type P53. These were all elderly, newly diagnosed AML patients with a median age of 72 years old. Unfortunately, the results demonstrated that the patients who have P53 mutations, they are doing fairly poor, with a median overall survival of only 5.2 months compared to 19.4 months with patients with the wild type P53. These patients tend to have low rates of MRD negativity of less than 20% compared to 50% in the other wild type cohort, higher initial mortality rates, and as I mentioned, significantly shorter overall survival. In fact, when we looked at our historical data with the 5 days or 10 days decitabine, the results were superimposable, indicating that venetoclax does not add in efficacy to the hypomethylating agents in this setting. Based on this data, in fact, at MD Anderson, we do not recommend using hypomethylating agents venetoclax for the P53 mutated acute myeloid leukemia patients, and preferably enroll them into the clinical trials with the newer agents such as the APR246 or magrolimab, excluding venetoclax.